about Cedar Rapids, you're going to have those communities within those that are going to be really hard affected. But, you know, you're talking Columbus Junction, maybe 1,000, 1,500 people, whereas Cedar Rapids, that's, I believe, 250,000 people live in that town. Those people really don't have a place to stay right now.
Gloves, plastic bags, shovels, rakes. Good. We're at the Woodland Trailer Park.
The number 44 down there. I have 8 families living in that house.
A lot of these trailers are filled with evacuees.
And we had an overpull of toothbrushes and toothpaste, the little things.
Exactly.
A can opener.
You should have heard me yesterday. They found me a can opener so I could open canned goods.
Yeah, the kids that can come in, you know, it's like, oh my gosh, I have a clean shirt I can put on, or I have shoes I can put on. It's the little things that make them happy.
All right, so we did everything on this list. We had four and three on the way out, and then we're going to hit Solid Rock Baptist Church.
All right.
All right? Yeah. So we're out of here.
Reach out and touch the flame where the streets have no name.
Where?
But definitely the fairgrounds.
Oh yeah, those guys could really use some help. We're just trying to survive at this point.
I hear you.
You know?
How many people you got staying here?
I've got 8 in my camp. We've got 12 over here. We just had more folks come in. They say there's 5 feet of water standing inside of our homes.
Right now they are they're in tents.
And they have no idea where they're gonna go or what they're gonna do. We just gotta unload everything we get with these guys. All of it. Down the street. This is Willow Street.
We're still here, trying to survive. And it gets harder from day to day to answer your children's questions. I've got a 4-year-old that asks me every day when we can go home. And I can't tell him when we're going home because we don't know.